When stars are bigger and contain much more mass than our sun, they can end their lives in a violent way called a supernova. Once they run out of fuel to burn, some massive stars collapse onto themselves. Some of the material is then ejected out into the universe. Astronomers are trying to understand exactly how stars disperse these life-giving elements into space during the deaths of stars. This 3D visualization, the first ever of its kind, depicts the supernova remnant of one such star in the Milky Way galaxy, called Cassiopeia A, or Cass A for short. When you look up at the stars at night, the light you see falls only on the visible spectrum of light. But that light is just a small sliver of the entire spectrum of light, or what's called the electromagnetic spectrum. The rest of the spectrum is composed of invisible types of radiation, such as gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet, infrared, and radio waves, which are all completely hidden from our unaided sight. This visualization is based on real data from multiple telescopes that measure across the electromagnetic spectrum. In this visualization, we are looking at X-ray data from NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory, infrared data from the Spitzer Space Telescope, and optical data from NOAA's 4-meter telescope at Kitt Peak and the Michigan Dartmouth MIT 2.4-meter telescope. The green region is mostly iron observed in X-rays. The yellow region is silicon, seen in X-rays, optical, and infrared. Outer debris seen in the optical is shown in cyan. The red region is argon, seen in the infrared. The blue reveals the outer blast wave, most prominently detected in X-rays. In magenta is neon, as seen in infrared wavelengths. In purple, two jets of material are seen. These jets funnel material and energy during and after the explosion. Why do we care about exploded stars? Well, these stars that expel all their insides out into the universe, they create the elements of life. So the iron, the silicon, the sulfur, they're created inside the stars and then distributed out into the universe to form new stars, new planets, new stuff. The iron in our blood, for example, or the calcium in our bones, those elements are from previous generations of massive stars.